Hi friends, Mrs. McBride here. Hope everybody is doing well. When hearing that we won't be going back to school this year, I was pretty disappointed, as I'm sure you guys were too. Wish that we'd be able to get back together in class. But since we won't, you're stuck listening to me and my jokes on YouTube. Here we go. Why did the pig have to sit on the bench during football practice? He pulled his hamstring. All right, so what we're doing today is we're talking about capacitors. Now, you did a lab the other day with capacitors, and what capacitors are is something that stores charge, okay? So before we get too into this, you'll definitely need your calculator today and also your green sheet, which again, mine is a white sheet, okay? So what a capacitor is something that stores charge. Okay, and the way that it stores charge is that there are these two parallel plates and they're separated by this distance D, okay? And you saw in the lab that if you change the size of the plate and you change the distance that they're separated, it changes the capacitance. Now the capacitance is sort of like resistance, where it's a natural property of the capacitor and it will tell you how much charge it can store. Okay, the higher the capacitance, the more charge that will be stored. Now, why would you want a capacitor? A capacitor works sort of like a battery in which they both will provide charge and therefore voltage. A capacitor can be used over and over again, whereas a battery has a specific lifetime. Your battery can run out of the chemical reaction and therefore won't work. A capacitor can be charged and charged and charged. Now, where would you find a capacitor? The most common one is in your phone. When you go to turn on your flash, the flash will, when it says it's ready, that means the capacitor is charged. And once your flash goes off, then it releases all of its charge and lights the light bulb, which is your flash. And then what it will do is it will charge itself back up again. That way you can take another picture with flash. Okay, so let me put a couple more things here. Again, this is two parallel plates. Separated by an insulating material. Okay. What do you think would be a good symbol for capacitance? Lucky for you, it's capital C. And the units you might have noticed were F, okay? And F stands for farad. Now, there was a famous American physicist named Michael Faraday, but they thought Faraday would be too long, so they just called it the farad and then abbreviated to F, okay? One farad is very, very large. So a lot of times when we're working capacitance, we're going to use microfarads. And just as a reminder, micro is really 10 to the negative 6 farads. Okay. And there's two really important equations. So first of all, what equations have we been using a lot of? Well, we've been using a lot of our friend V equals IR, which says that voltage and current and resistance are all related. There is an equation that is similar that we're going to use just like V equals IR for capacitors. And that one is Q equals VC. QVC, isn't that everybody's favorite home shopping network? Some of you might not know what a home shopping network is. That's what they had before they had the internet, is that this was a channel that played infomercials the entire day. That way you could just watch the channel and buy stuff and have it sent directly to your home. QVC. I don't actually know what QVC really stands for. Okay, but in physics, Q is the charge, V is the voltage, and C is the capacitance. QVC, okay? Now, I told you, I ran out of room here on my on my green sheet. So I'm just gonna go over here and I want you to write, again, that our equation is Q equals VC. And we should have everything that we need over here, except for, let's go ahead and add that C is capacitance and that it's measured in farads, okay? I got a couple more things that we're gonna add here, so keep this handy. And the second equation that we're gonna talk about today is how do you actually calculate the capacitance? Well, we said that it really depended on two different factors, the size of the plate and the distance they're separated. And I hope you notice that the size of the plate, as the size of the plate increased, the capacitance increased, which means that they're both up here on the top. I skipped a space there on purpose, okay? And then you should have noticed that the closer these two parallel plates got, the higher the capacitance. So the distance that's separated would be on the bottom, okay? And there's one last thing that goes here, and this is called epsilon naught. It looks kind of like a lowercase c with a line through the center and then a naught sign. This is called epsilon naught, okay? And we're gonna use these two equations together because we could use this to find C and this to find other things or vice versa. You're gonna go back and forth a lot, okay? Now let's write this out in words and then I'll talk to you about what epsilon naught is because we're gonna wanna write that down too. Okay, so what this one says is this says capacitance. Pretend like I spelled that right, okay? Sorry about that. I think I'm missing an I. Capacitance, capacitance, I'm not sure, okay. Now this epsilon naught here is called the permittivity of free space, but that doesn't really mean anything to me. So I'm just going to write that this is epsilon naught times the area of the capacitor. This is the area of the plates divided by the distance they are separated. Okay. And again, what is this epsilon naught? This has a value of 8.85 e to the negative 12, and the units here are capacitance squared, oh I lied, this is Coulomb squared divided by newtons times meters squared, okay? So let's go ahead and write this down over here on our green sheet. I'm gonna write down the equation that C equals epsilon naught A over D, okay? Now, if you want to write down what D is, go ahead and do that over there, or you can do it over here, it's up to you. The D equals the distance separated. A is the area. And everybody's favorite, epsilon naught is equal to 8.85 E to the negative 12, C squared, divided by n times m squared, okay? I'm sure you're thinking to yourself, gee, are there any practice problems that we could do on this? Why, yes, there are. Here we go. So this one says, the plates of a parallel plate capacitor are separated by a distance of 1 millimeter. First of all, you should be saying to yourself, we don't use millimeters. We'll have to convert that. What must the plate area be if the capacitance is 1 farad, which is pretty big? Okay, so what information do we have in the problem so far? Well, to me, first of all, we have the distance that they're separated, which they gave us to be 1 millimeter. But again, we're not gonna use it in terms of millimeters. We know there are 1,000 millimeters in 1 meter, or if we divide this by 1,000, we get 0.001 meters. We're looking for the area, and it gives us the capacitance of 1 farad. Okay, so which equation are we going to use here, number one or number two? Hopefully you're saying number two because, hey, we don't have the charge or the voltage, so we have to use this. Plus, that's the only equation that has A in there. All right, so let's start with C equals epsilon naught A over D. Okay, or we've got 1 equals 8.85 e to the negative 12 times our area divided by our distance. Okay, so to get the 0.001 out of the denominator, I'm gonna multiply both sides by 0.001, or you should get that 0.001 equals 8.85 e to the negative 12 times my area. Okay, or in order to solve for the area, we're gonna take that 0.001 divided by 8.85 e to the negative 12. So here we go. 0.001 divided by 8.85 e to the negative 12. Okay, and we get this huge number. Let's see, let's toss this in scientific notation here for a second. 1.1 times 10 to the 8th meters squared. Okay, so I get the area would be 1.1 e to the 8 meters squared. Now, if you think about it, this is square meters, so this is a huge, 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 huge number. The reason I like to do this is because this problem doesn't make any sense. We wouldn't have an area that was that big. If you think about it, if we then take the square root of this number, figuring that the capacitor is a square, okay, we get, let's put this back into regular, we get that the area or one side of our triangle would have to be 10,000 meters. Okay, 10,000 meters is really, 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 really large distance, okay? So we would never have a capacitor that's that big, which makes sense because we said a capacitance of 1 farad is crazy too. Okay, one more problem for today. This one says, the effective area of each plate of a parallel plate capacitor is 1.3 meters squared. When a 5-volt potential difference, and I wanted to point this out here, potential difference, this is just a key word for voltage. A lot of people ask me that question about the lab. So again, potential difference, same thing as voltage, exists across plates of the capacitor. The capacitor stores 1 microcoulomb, remember I said to be on the lookout for that, of charge. Determine the plate separation of the capacitor. Okay, so there's a lot there. Let's go ahead and start unpacking this. So if we read through again, the effective area of each plate of a capacitor is 1.3. So this is the area. When a 5-volt potential difference, so the voltage is 5, exists across the plates of the capacitor stores 1 microcoulomb of charge. Okay, so again, the charge is 1 microcoulomb or 1 e to the negative 6. You're looking for determine the plate separation of the capacitor. Now, here we go. We're looking to find the plate separation of the capacitor, but there's one problem. You seeing what I'm seeing? We've got this, but we don't have this. So this is a good example of when we need to use these two equations first. So if we use this first equation to find C, then if we take C, we can put it in here to find D. You with me? If you think you got it, pause the video or fast forward and see what you got. Check your answer versus mine. If you'd like to go along with me, that's cool. All right, so I'm gonna start with Q equals VC, or 1 e to the negative 6 equals 5C. Okay, so if I take and divide 1 e to the negative 6 divided by 5, I should get, oh, let's scientific notation that. I get 2 e to the negative 7. Okay, so my capacitance, we said it was going to be small, which makes sense. 2 e to the negative 7 F. Excuse me. All right, now we can use C equals epsilon naught A over D. All right, so if we go ahead and plug our capacitance in here, we get 2 e to the negative 7 equals 8.85 e to the negative 11. Did I say 11? Because I totally meant 12. Times our area of 1.3 divided by the distance. Okay, so I'm just gonna go over here. If I solve this, if I multiply both sides by d, d comes over here, and I'm gonna divide by this number, or I get 8.85 e to the negative 12 times 1.3 divided by 2 e to the negative 7. 8.85 e to the negative 12 times 1.3 divided by 2 e to the negative 7. I get 5.75 e to the negative 5. So here's my distance. 5.75 e to the negative 5 meters. All right, which makes sense because that's pretty small. All right, thanks friends. Hope to see you soon.